Welcome to RJ classes, and today we will do Newton's second law of motion. Second law of motion. The first law of the motion, force, that all were completed. So in the second law, there is about the momentum. So first of all, let's understand momentum, then we will describe the second law, momentum. Momentum, because the second law of motion states the relation between the force and the momentum, so there is necessity to understand momentum. So what is momentum? The product of mass and velocity of an object. Mass and velocity. So product of mass and velocity is said to be the momentum. So mathematically it is represented as momentum equals to mass into velocity, that is the mv. We can write it mv. And for the unit, you can write the unit. For the mass, it is the kg, and velocity, meter per second. So it will be kg meter per second. It is the unit for the momentum. So momentum, if you need to define the momentum, the product of mass, and simply write on the product of mass and velocity of an object is said to be its momentum. Now in second law, Newton has related the momentum to the applied force. That means the momentum, change in momentum, the behavior of momentum, that is completely depend upon the force applied. So what is the second law of motion? The second law of motion states that the rate of change of momentum, and I always say that whenever we discuss about the rate of change of momentum, rate, that means anything, whenever the rate of change, that means anything, if divided by time, that describes the rate of change. Rate of change, that means divide the given quantity means with time, so that will give you the value of rate of change of momentum. So here the second law is rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the applied force. What I'm talking about? So Newton's second law describes the rate of change of momentum of a body is directly proportional to the applied force, and the change in momentum take place in the direction of the force applied. So I'm writing the definition, writing the second law first, then we will describe it when we will get the derivation from the second law. So second law states that rate of change of momentum, rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to, is directly proportional to the applied force, and change in momentum take place, take place in the direction of force applied. Okay, so we got the second law, that means the force is directly proportional. So if we write it mathematically, force is directly proportional, force applied will decide the rate of change of momentum. Force applied will decide how much momentum will get changed. So that is, the force is directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. Momentum. Okay, so the second law is clear, and from the second law we need to find F equals to ma. From the second law there is much more things to do. The first thing we need to prove that from the second law, that is the F equals to ma. Now let's start. Suppose an object having the mass m, moving with a initial velocity u, having the final velocity v, after time t its acceleration reaches to the kya jayega a, and it again having the acceleration a. So if we have these values, and from these values we have to prove that F equals to ma. So first of all, momentum. So momentum equals to, and momentum equals to mass into velocity, okay. And so mass, we have the mass m, and the velocity. So velocity, we will take the rate of change of velocity. So velocity is v minus u. So velocity, we have the v minus u. That is the change in velocity we are taking. So and we have to find the rate of change of momentum. Rate. So in order to find the rate, we always divide the given quantity with time. So we have now finally the momentum is equals to mv minus u by t, because body has the initial velocity u, the final velocity v, and the velocity that we will take, that will be the difference of the two velocities. So change in velocities. So because, okay, we can do it like this one. So if initial momentum, we are finding first of all initial momentum, that will be very better, or you can understand it more clearly in this way. Initial momentum, momentum equals to, that is the mu, for the final momentum. So you will write it in sentence: let an object having the mass m, having the initial velocity u, having the final velocity v, time taken is t, and the acceleration is a. After writing this all, we will start from this section. So initial momentum, that is the mu, final momentum, final momentum, that is the mv, mass into velocity. Change in momentum, change in momentum, we are going to find the relation f equals to ma. Change in momentum, momentum equals to, that is the mv minus mu, equals to mv minus u, because mass of an object does not change, so it will be mv minus u. And rate of change, rate of change of momentum, rate of change of momentum, momentum equals to m v minus u by t. And we know that the rate of change in velocity, v minus u by t, what is this section represent? If we take a look at this section, so v minus u by t represent the acceleration. That means rate of change of, what is the definition of acceleration? Rate of change of velocity of an object is called acceleration. So it will be ma. Now we got ma. So from the second law, if we write it, force applied, force is directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. Momentum. So F, if we have the force applied F, you can write it here, F, force applied is F. So F is directly proportional to ma, and F equals to kma, where k is the proportionality constant. So if k equals to 1, in that situation F will be equals to the ma. So we got our derivation, F equals to ma. Simple things to do. So certain things you will have to let, that is the force, initial velocity, final velocity, acceleration, time, and you can get the derivation F equals to ma from the Newton's second law. Now there is another way also we miss, by which we can prove that F equals to ma. Now let, so what we have in second law, that the rate of change of velocity, sorry, rate of change of momentum. So other way is F, force is directly proportional to alternate method. Other method is rate of change of momentum. So F is proportional to momentum, is we have the momentum, that is the mv. And the, in order to find the rate of change of momentum, I always still divide the given quantity with time. You will get the rate of change of momentum. So F proportional to mv. So that is the force is directly proportional to. So we need to find the change in momentum. So F proportional to del mv by del t. Okay. But mass of an object never changes. So we have F proportional to m del v by del t. And rate of change of velocity, that will be equals to the acceleration. So F proportional to ma. And F equals to kma, where k is the proportionality constant. If k equals to 1, so under that situation, F equals to ma. So it means by any of the method you can prove. So you cannot write it directly here. You can start with here, let in momentum equals to, momentum equals to mv, change in momentum equals to del mv, and rate of change of momentum, that is the del P by del T equals to del MV by del T, and means keeping the M is constant, always remain constant, so del means V by del T. You can also write, or you can start with here, so whatever you like you can do. So from the second law we got the derivation that F equals to MA, and from here we are going to get the first law. How? Okay, so from here we can describe first law of the motion also from the second law. So what we got from the second law, from this first law we are going to derive the, from the second law we are going to derive the first law of the motion. So that is, from the second law we have the derivation, that is the F equals to MA. F equals to MA. Okay, so F equals to MA, if F equals to 0, that means force is being not applied on the enemies any object. So what was the first law? First law, if the force is not applied on an object, any external force is not applied on an object, object will remain in a state of rest or in a state of motion. So if F equals to 0, that means the value of MA equals to 0. Mass cannot be 0. Mass of an object cannot be equals to 0. Therefore A equals to 0. That means acceleration is being not applied on the object. If there is no acceleration, that means if object is in rest, it will be in rest, and if it is in motion, it will be in a state of motion. So that is the nothing but the first law of the motion. So the from the first, second law of the motion, we also get the kya jayega information about the first law. So this is the Newton's second law of motion. Derivation, we understood the derivation, F equals to MA, and from the relation F equals to MA we also got the definition of the first law of the motion. We describe the first law of the motion. Now there are certain graphs that we need to do. So first graph, that is the means acceleration with force, acceleration and force. Okay, before doing the graph we are going to find the relation between the force and acceleration. So how force and acceleration are related to each other? F equals to MA, so force is directly proportional to acceleration. And how is force related to mass? F is directly proportional to the mass. And whenever we do the graph, in the graph section I have already described, so if it is directly proportional, it will be a straight line passing through the origin. So means we are doing the graph, so we have, in order to do the graph, we have acceleration y-axis and the force at the x-axis. So force and acceleration are directly related to each other. That means, so in order to do the graph, it will be a straight line passing through the origin. So this one is the graph of the force and acceleration. Amidst the next graph we are going to do with the force and the mass, that is force and mass are also directly related to each other. So here we have the force and here is the mass. So if we need to do the graph, so it will also a straight line passing through the origin, it will be a graph. And the third graph, if relation between the MA, so if from here we find the value of M or A, so A equals to F by M, that means A and M are inversely related to each other. So whenever there is the inverse graph, inversely related to each other, it will be a curved line. For directly proportional, it will be a straight line passing through the origin, and for the inversely proportional, it will be a curved line. So we are going to do the graph acceleration and the mass. So here acceleration and the mass. So acceleration and mass is will be a curved line. You can draw it like this one. So for not only the acceleration and the mass, for any of the relation that is inversely proportional to each other, so in that situation we can draw the graph like this one. So this one is the second law of motion. So in next video we will do the next section.